Hey there guys, Paul here. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through some examples for the selection of multi-ejectors for transcritical CO2 refrigeration applications. Coming up, selecting a high-pressure multi-ejector, selecting a low-pressure multi-ejector, selecting a liquid multi-ejector for a system with CO2 adaptive liquid management, generating a report, and generating a bill of materials. This video is part of a series where we'll be looking at a number of worked examples using the Coolselector 2 application to help you select and calculate components for your refrigeration system. So do check out the other videos if you haven't already. Links are in the video description below. We start the selection for an ejector by heading to the Valves and Line Components tab and then selecting the Multi-Ejector option. We begin from the top left-hand panel. First, we need to define the system, which in this case defines the type of ejector that we want to use in our system. On the system diagram, you can see the ejector setup. In this video, we'll go through the selection procedure for all three types of ejectors. You can see that Coolselector 2 has chosen transcritical HP for the system type as default. High-pressure ejectors are used to enhance systems with parallel compression. HP ejectors enhance the system performance by lifting the pressure of MT evaporator outlet using the gas cooler outlet and expanding into the receiver. In the case of a HP ejector, the bypass gas is handled by the IT compressor. We can choose another system from the drop-down menu. In this case, we'll leave this as HP. For the refrigerant, you'll notice that Coolselector 2 has also defaulted to CO2. Additionally, the product family has already been selected for the multi-ejector HP. We need to first define our operating conditions before we can select a product. We do that in the top center panel. We will set our low temperature cooling capacity to 30 kilowatts, our medium temperature cooling capacity to 210 kilowatts, and our air conditioning capacity to 0 kilowatts. The air conditioning load uses the liquid in the receiver for cooling of a secondary medium to be used in air conditioning, which can be set if we have such a system. For our low temperature evaporation temperature, we require negative 30 degrees Celsius. Our medium temperature evaporation temperature, we require negative 10 degrees Celsius. And our gas cooler outlet temperature will be 35 degrees Celsius. We want to control the receiver at 3 degrees Celsius without any extra subcooling. Coolselector 2 now displays the relevant products. We can see that one product is highlighted in green. This is the suggested product. It is suggested based on our inputs, and we should check the performance details to ensure it is compatible with our system. We can see that the capacity load on the ejectors allows an increase in capacity if necessary. You can also notice that based on the required capacity in our system, Coolselector 2 specifies the number of ejectors required to be installed on the gas cooler line. In the performance section at the lowest segment of the window, we have some charts plotted within the envelope tab. These show our motive envelope with gas cooler outlet temperature against the gas cooler pressure. This envelope represents where ejectors operate, and the upper line shows the optimum COP line. We also have the suction receiver envelope showing the ejector suction superheat and the MT evaporator suction pressure working point inside the area where calculations are valid based on measurements. In the performance details tab, we can find thermodynamic data, system schematics, and either a pressure enthalpy chart. Once you have made your selection, you can either generate a report or generate a bill of materials using the buttons in the top menu bar. We now open a new tab and choose the multi-ejectors from valves and line components again. Then we choose the transcritical LP ejector from the drop-down menu. Low-pressure ejectors can be used as an enhancement to booster systems. As you can see, in this case the system is similar to a booster system, but the MT evaporator outlet returns the ejector to be lifted using the gas cooler outlet and then expanded to the receiver. This enables us to lift the pressure from the LT evaporators to our receiver pressure and mix it with saturated gas from the receiver without a pressure drop in the bypass valve and hence improve the system performance. You can notice that Coolselector 2 kept our operating conditions from the previous selection. However, the receiver temperature or pressure cannot be set anymore. This is because in the case of LP ejectors, the receiver pressure is a function of other system operating conditions and the selected ejector performance. The current capacity is too high for the LP ejectors. In our case, the LP ejectors work at a different operating condition, so we'll input the new operating conditions now. There is a difference between the receiver pressure and the MT evaporator's pressure that you can notice after the calculation of the receiver pressure. We'll enter 10 kilowatts for the LT capacity and 60 kilowatts for the MT capacity. We'll then input an LT evaporation temperature of negative 30 degrees Celsius with 6 Kelvin of useful superheat and 4 Kelvin of additional superheat. For the MT evaporator, we'll choose pressure from the drop-down menu and then enter 28 bar. For the gas cooler, we'll use an outlet temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. We can see the selection results and our choices in the table where we can choose the product we would like to use in our system. The calculated receiver pressure and entrainment ratio are shown in the table. You can also see the ejector envelope similar to the previous case. Once you have made your selection, we can either generate a report or generate a bit of materials using the buttons in the top menu bar. Liquid ejectors enable the system to use Danfoss CO2 Adaptive Liquid Management Solutions, or CALM for short. CALM allows full utilization of the evaporator surface in display cases and cold rooms, as it improves the energy savings with CO2 refrigeration applications. Using CALM, the evaporator is controlled so that the outlet fluid is as close as possible to saturated gas to maximize evaporation surface utilization. As a result, you can use a higher evaporation temperature while goods are kept at the same temperature compared to an evaporator with superheat. Running the evaporators in this mode results in more or less 3% liquid at the outlet of the evaporator, which needs to be captured with a suction accumulator. The ejector takes care of this extra liquid. We click on the New tab at the top of the screen. We can then select a new component for our project. Under the Valves and Line Components tab, we again select Multi Ejectors. Now we select Transcritical LE Ejector from the drop-down menu. You'll see that Coolselector 2 has changed some of the operating conditions compared to our previous selection. This is because, in the case of liquid ejectors, for a system equipped with CALM, the MT evaporators do not require a superheat to function properly, and hence we can increase the evaporation pressure. Furthermore, the main dimensioning input for the gas cooler conditions is the minimum gas cooler temperature, which is the outlet temperature at winter conditions. The receiver conditions should be updated as well. Here we can choose a system with capacity similar to the previous case, but we can set the receiver temperature to 0 degrees Celsius, the MT evaporator temperature to negative 4 degrees Celsius, and the minimum outlet temperature of the gas cooler to 15 degrees Celsius. You should ensure you enter the receiver temperature first before entering or changing the evaporator temperature to avoid potential errors. You can see the suggested product by Coolselector 2. This is a suggestion based on the varying load in our system and other parameters. Now that we have selected our products, we can generate a report or a bill of materials by clicking on the buttons in the top menu bar. We'll look at that in the next segment of this video. We can generate a report for our selected products simply by clicking on the Report button in the top menu bar. The window will then refresh to display our product report. In the left-hand panel, under Items to Include in the Report, we can add or remove information from our report by clicking on the plus button and then selecting or unselecting the item. If we make a change here, simply click the Update button at the top to apply the changes. Additionally, we have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name to the report using the inputs on the top left-hand panel. Again, if you make a change here, then simply click the Update button to apply these. Along the top of the report, we also have various options to export the report. We can generate a bill of materials which can be provided to a Danfoss supplier to obtain a quotation by clicking on the Bill of Materials button in the top menu bar. Here the product quantity, the product description, and the code numbers will be displayed. In the left-hand panel, we also have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name using the inputs. If you make a change here, just click the Update button to apply this. Along the top of the Bill of Materials, we also have a number of buttons to export the Bill of Materials. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed this and it has helped you. If so, then please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you have any questions at all, let us know in the comments section down below. You can also find links to more Coolselector tutorials in the video description. Do check those out, and once again, thanks for watching.